never be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do.
Yeah, game over.
That the weight has lifted. Love has surely shifted my way. Marry me. Stay in every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together can never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you. And you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. Marry me. Stay in every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will.
Who gives their blessing for this woman and this man to become husband and wife?
Her grandfather. Or someone.
Excellent. Please be seated. I'm going to go off script real quick and let you guys know that I'm going to be a blubbering idiot by the time this is over.
Oh, good. Me too.
I'm going to thoroughly embarrass myself. Scott, Maddie, before we get started, I'd just like you to take a deep breath, try to relax. Everything's going to be okay. It's all going to be over soon. My proctologist told me that last week. It's a different context, but I thought it might help. Friends and family, I'd like to welcome you all to my wedding. I say my because as a deputy commissioner of civil marriages, which I take very seriously, I get to do all the talking and you guys get to do all the listening. Until I say those magic words, you are not married, son. For anyone that doesn't already know, I'm Scott's dad, and we come together today to celebrate the forthcoming marriage of Madeline Michelle Cooley and my son, Donald Scott Folk. Marriage is a sincere and mutual commitment to love one another and to work towards creating a life together in an atmosphere of care, consideration, and respect. This civil ceremony is every bit as binding as the most solemn religious ceremony a couple could have. Before we get into the formalities of the wedding, I've been given a couple of messages that I would like to read aloud. They're from guests that were unable to attend today's festivities. Now, I have not read these myself, so hopefully they're appropriate.
This is going to be awesome.
Dear Scott, we will miss your constant service, as it is impossible to replace a customer as loyal and frequent as you. Best of luck. With all our love, the ladies of the Swedish Touch Massage Parlor.
Can you put that in my pocket, please?
Wow.
Oh, there's more.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Well, one of your friends came.
Oh, no.
Thank you. Dear Maddie, I hope the fact that you're now married will not change things between us. I love the way you put your hands all over me and kiss me all over. You will always have my heart. Love always, Bob. For those who don't know, Bob is their dog. Okay. Back to my place here. Okay. Marriage is not a word. It's a sentence. A life sentence. And there could be... come on, this is sincere now. Believe it or not. There could not be two better people on this earth to serve that sentence together. This is the point in the ceremony when traditionally an audience is polled to see if there are any objections to the marriage. No objections?
You leaving me out?
Well, actually, I might object on behalf of each of you individually. Seeing that two of you are about to embark upon the journey of life, let's take a couple minutes to talk about choices. Maddie, since I believe in ladies first, I'm going to start with you.
Uh-oh.
And with your permission, I'm going to step into a bit of a father role and talk about your choice of my son as your potential husband.
You have my permission?
I've got to tell you, I've got some real concerns here. I did a little digging, and I found some rather interesting images from the internet that I'd like to ask you about. Before we start, though, let me just say that all but one of these images are ones that the two of you posted yourselves. So there shouldn't be any surprises here. Now, I can't say if alcohol was involved in the factor of you deciding to post, but
yes.
You posted them, so I'm free to use them.
It's like a job interview.
Now, as a father, I would naturally want to marry someone, I would naturally want you to marry someone with strong leadership qualities. Perhaps someone who really knows what he wants in life and who has the fortitude to make it happen. So, is this representative of that strong leader?
Absolutely.
And for those that can't read it, it says, I am the Grand Poobah of the Loyal Order of Water Buffaloes. It's a Flintstones reference, of course. Okay. So let's move on to career choice. As a father, I would... Oh, your turn's coming, buddy. As a father, I would expect an ideal husband to be able to provide a nice, comfortable home for his wife and family, and being gainfully employed, preferably in a career field that he is truly passionate about. And that says, not now, my precious. Maddie will never come between us.
Not to worry.
Yeah, not to worry. Oh, so.
You just turn that one around.
Just hide that, please.
So tell me, Maddie, what's the deal here? Is there such a thing as too much passion?
Apparently. That would be the first gun Scott ever built me, for the record. He was, yeah. Yeah. Leave
okay.
It that.
Let's move on to fidelity.
Oh no.
Keep in mind, this came from the internet. Marriage is a sacred commitment between two people. And frankly, many couples do not survive the temptations that pass their way on a daily basis. I honestly need to tell you that I have great concern in Scott's ability to remain faithful. I mean, with the massage parlor and all his out-of-town travel. I'm just afraid you might get hurt one of these days. And how often does he travel out of town?
for the record, I took that photo.
Well, that's okay, because it says, it's okay, baby. Maddie's cool with it. Getting warmed up. So, as a father, I have to ask, what do you really know about this guy and his lifestyle? Has he ever shown any indication that he might like to play in a different sandbox than the rest of us? Some of us get it. And what's the deal with his tongue always hanging out? Since mine's bigger than yours. Just wondering. Okay. Here's the coup de grace. All right, Maddie. I have one more to share with you. And this one actually creeps me out. So I don't even know where to begin other than to say, really? That one says, you think this looks good, you should see the rest. So, do we still think it's a good idea for me to be up here?
He's your son.
I'm just getting around, just getting wound up. Okay, son. Let's talk candidly for just a moment about women. And while we're at it, let's go ahead and play a little game I'm going to call, what are you thinking? So every time I show you an image, the question I'm going to ask you is, really? You know she's a redhead, right?
I think someone told me once.
And you know she's quite proficient in the use of firearms.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's get started. A father's fondest wish for his son is that he would find himself a loving, caring, and adoring woman. One who completes his very existence. One who makes him feel like no other ever has before. One that will bring stability, love, and comfort into his world. And most of all, that one special woman to be the mother of his children. A mother should be a good role model for her children, and as such, be stable and level-headed. So, really? She's the one you chose?
Oh, yeah.
How dare you call me crazy. And by the way, speaking of grandchildren, Marianne and I only have 9, so we're looking for you to step up to the plate. You know what I'm saying?
You got it. Okay.
Now, as a mother, she'll most likely be the one planning and providing meals. You, as a husband, may want to be gentle when inquiring as to a meal's readiness. What's for dinner? I'll tell you what's for dinner. So, are you really ready for this marriage?
Yes, ma'am.
Speaking of the kitchen and meals, I'd be real careful if I were you when it comes time to get your wife any new kitchen gadgets. Says, you want a piece of this?
Guest in the crowd got that for me.
You don't have to explain, it's all right. I'm not judging. I'm here just to, you know, officiate. So, is this really the woman for you?
Oh, yeah.
Flames, guns.
Okay, let's get out of the house for a minute and talk about work. You know, the one thing a guy can usually count on is being able to go to work and get away from the occasional stresses of being a husband. At least at work, there won't be any honey-do list waiting for you. Of course, if you were to make the mistake of providing the little lady with the key to your shop, you might have to find yourself a new getaway. And this one says, you think I'm a bit crazy, do you? Now, Scott, hold on a second. You did notice this grown, otherwise mature woman wearing bunny ears, right?
Oh, yeah. That's why I'm marrying her.
Okay. So the question again, really?
Huh?
Speaking of honeydews, there will be times when your dear sweet bride may become a bit frustrated at what she perceives as your laziness because you're, quote, sitting on your butt while she's out working in the yard to make the house look better for the neighbors. And it says, how many times do I have to tell you to mow this damn yard? Again, really?
She's a keeper.
Doing my best impression of Gandalf there. You shall not pass.
Okay, son. If I don't have you thinking by now, this next one is probably not going to make any difference at all, but I had to include it. You see, when you make your own decisions, you're the one that has to live with the consequences. I'm just going to let this one speak for itself. So if you think I'm crazy now, just wait till I get you home, mister. Again, I have to ask, really?
Yep.
I do actually have one last image in my Inquisition series to ask you guys about. But I'm not sure which one of you can best answer it. Just exactly how does this work anyway? And this one says, I'm getting real tired of you guys peeing on my lawn. Well, that went better than I expected. You guys didn't toss me out. I didn't see any guns drawn.
Yet.
So I guess I have to retract my objections and give you my blessings. You're welcome. There are some more in a few minutes. Son, standing here, you may think differently, but you have absolutely no idea how fortunate you are to have the love of this wonderful woman, Madeline Michelle Cooley. If I had been tasked with having to choose for you, I would have struck gold because I just hit the mother lode. Marianne and I dearly love her as a daughter, and there is nothing we would change about her. The only thing I ask is, that you grant an old man a selfish wish and give him another grandchild before he graduates from college. You've got a little less than 2 years. Maddie, I know you truly love Scott and know that he is one of the most loving, compassionate, and giving men you could ever find. So I would like to share a picture with you. This is a photo I'm pretty sure nobody has ever seen, perhaps including Scott himself.
No.
What I have is a picture of true internal peace and happiness.
Did you make a Grey Gun?
This says Scott's outlook on life. Now, I think the caption speaks for itself, but let me put this photo in context. First of all, you'll notice he's at work. This is when he used to work for my brother at SAC EDM. Not his own work, not even involving his true passion as a pistolsmith. Yet, he has a huge smile on his face, and he's dancing. He's not high, but rather just intoxicated on life itself. He knows there are great things in store for he and his family, which now, of course, includes you. I searched through hundreds and hundreds of pictures, and I'm here to tell you that I could not find a single one where Scott wasn't smiling from ear to ear. Maddie, with a man like this standing beside you, you're destined to have a truly wonderful life. There's one final image. This is selfish on my part, but I think it's appropriate. Is a rather poor quality image, but I had no choice in what to get. So I'll share it with you along with my thoughts. So it says, like father, like son. I'm so proud of this picture that my daughter has put together for me for a recent birthday, which shows Scott and myself in a similar pose. That's Stephanie and Scott, with they're next to me.
Louie, it's okay.
The last thing I have to say is something I wish for my son, that one day he is standing up here in front of family and friends in order to say out loud that his son had turned out to be the man that he always knew he was going to be and more. Together, you two will make wonderful parents. Okay, let's get on to the hitching part. Maddie, will you take Scott to be your lawfully wedded husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and cherish him, and be faithful to him and him alone, in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, for better or worse, throughout all the days of your life?
I do.
Scott, will you take Maddie to be your lawfully wedded wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and cherish her, and be faithful to her and her alone, in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity, for better or worse, throughout all the days of your life?
I do.
Scott and Maddie would like to now share their personal vows with each other. I'm not sure which one wanted to go first, but since I'm running the show, Scott, you're going to go first.
I don't think I can top you.
I don't think I can either. We should just stop now.
My dearest Maddie, I love you for so many reasons, I can hardly begin to cover them all. But I want to relive a few with you right now. I love the way you sit there and smile at me from across the room when you don't think I'm watching, but I notice. I love the sparkle in your eyes when you wake up every morning to a kiss. I love how excited you get over the simplest gifts I bring you, for no reason whatsoever. I love how you and I are complete geeks and see eye to eye on everything sci-fi related. Thank you, dear. I love the Wi-Fi we have amongst each other. The point where I can tell you the punchline of your joke before you get to it. And I love the goofballs we are when we're together. We can act like total goobers and not regret a minute of it. Today I'm marrying the best friend I've ever had. You're my everything and you make me smile when I don't want to. You have been my moral compass when I needed guidance.
Excuse me.
I want to grow old with you and share every minute of my life with you. Thank you. I want to have children together and watch them grow right before our eyes. I promise to love and cherish and respect you for the rest of my life. I promise to put you to bed every night with a kiss. And wake you... excuse me. And wake you every morning with another. I promise to grow old with you and support you in every way I possibly can, no matter how difficult things may be. And I promise to build you custom guns. To remind you that you are, and always will be, my favorite shooting buddy.
I can't top that. Let's see if I can talk. I think we have to stand close because I'm on your mic.
Okay. My dear Scotty, 5 years ago today, I saw your infectious smile for the first time. And you're right, it's never left his face. Over the next 2 years, you became my best friend. You were there for me when I needed to cry on a shoulder, talk something out, or just lay on the beach with a cocktail and the girls. In other words, I did. When we started dating, I thought it was too good to be true. And it is. I remember 2 years ago vividly at the IRC when we first started dating, and I wanted so badly to be with you. I'm happy to be here. I kind of put some things together with Scott's direction, because I'm terrible at writing things to say in front of people. So some things that I love about you are some of our silly habits, like Friday night Chinese takeout and Star Trek reruns cuddled up on the couch. I love how much you enjoy seeing me smile and how you just can't help but spoil me because of it. The breakfast in bed, flowers at work, freshly loaded .45 ammo. The moons, the whole nine yards. I love that you are the kindest, most gentlest, most patient, respecting man that I have ever met. I mean that. Some things that I want with you, and that you are me. You are my lover and my best friend. You accept my flaws and have been patient enough to help me work through tough times and become a better version of myself. You are the sunshine in my day and the moonlight of my night, and I may or may not have stolen that from someone. You keep me smiling always with your playfulness, your humor, your wisecrack jokes, not to mention your endless voicemails from your alter egos as my various foreign lovers.
Do we need a picture for reference?
No.
Do you have one?
They all have very sexy accents, by the way. Including Boris, the Russian. You and I are a team, which I love. I love shooting matches by your side and teaching shooting clinics and events, hashing out stages, spending time with friends on the range, and most of all, sharing our love of the sport with others. Thank you for putting up with my endless volunteering, grant writing, event coordination, and the things that I always seem to suck you into along with me. Promises. I promise to support you in all your endeavors as a business owner, as a competitor, as a husband, as a father, and as a man. When times are hard, I will be there to keep you company and pull you through. When times are joyous, I will be there to share with your laughter and your bliss. I promise to bear our children, but no more than four. It's a point of much contention amongst us. I will be the best mother that I know how to be. And you know that's a lot coming from me. I promise to love you through all our years until we're so old that we get Alzheimer's and we get the chance to fall in love all over again.
Okay, we're going to do the ring exchange?
I believe so. Lulu.
Do I need it yet?
He's the best ring bearer, isn't he?
Maddie's going to go first. Maddie, take the ring and place it on Scott's left ring finger and repeat these words after me. That's the one, dear, right there.
Thank you.
Scott, as I give you this ring.
Scott, as I give you this ring.
I choose you to be my husband.
I choose you to be my husband.
And I give to you.
And I give to you.
My unconditional love and affection.
My unconditional love and affection.
Scott, take the ring and place it on Maddie's left hand and repeat these words after me. Maddie, as I give you this ring.
Maddie, as I give you this ring.
I choose you to be my wife.
I choose you to be my wife.
And I give to you.
And I give to you.
My unconditional love and affection.
My unconditional love and affection.
The rings that have been exchanged are a perfect circle of precious metals. The circle is a symbol of completeness, an emblem of never-ending eternity. The precious metal has been taken from the earth, tested and proven to be true. The ring is such a fitting emblem of your love and adoration for each other. And in the test of time, like the gold that's been tested in fire, may your love and adoration for each other prove to be just as true and endure every bit as long. And now, inasmuch as Scott and Maddie have consented together in marriage and have declared the same before witnesses, and thereto have given and pledged their love and faithfulness to each other, by the authority vested in me, I pronounce you married under the laws of the state of California. Maddie, you may now kiss your groom. Caught you by surprise on that one. Huh?
Hey. I like the way you do business.
Today I welcome the newest addition to my family, Madeline Michelle Folk. I'll leave you both with four famous words immortalized by Spock. Live long and prosper. It's now with great pleasure that I present to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Donald Scott Folk.